Remember the days of the old schoolyard?
I remember them fondly, Johnny. Is that, was that a question or was that a statement?
Well, it came out as a question, didn't it? So it must have been.
Oh, were you telling me to remember them or were you asking me if I did remember them?
Both.
Okay.
This leads to the dungeons!
The deep, dark, rape dungeon?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Snape, I mean, well, she loves it. I mean, you just saw her being all excited.
Oh, she wants to go to the dungeon.
Well, she likes being, you know, she likes what Snape does to her.
In the dungeons.
See, we don't have the spell for this yet. So.
Oh, I thought you were supposed to fall down there or something.
No. Oh, like that. No. Ooh. You can jump up with this weird...
I really like the lighting, though, except casting
I was just about to say, yeah. That what?
What is that? Is there a skylight there or something?
Oh.
Like, how is there that big... Yeah. Oh, okay, there is.
Yeah, that's neat. They've thought of everything. Look, the spiders are there as well, like in the film, the tiny
follow
one.
The spiders, why couldn't it be following the butterflies?
What a fucking faggot.
Now pay attention. Today,
we
will attempt to learn the art of mixing one of the most useful potions ever concocted. The
Wigan
Weld potion. Potter, you have just volunteered to show the rest of the class how this is done. Get up here immediately.
Jeez, he really is magic. He can talk without opening his mouth.
No, I think he opened his mouth.
Will restore some of your lost stamina.
Stamina. Even a single bottle is capable of healing. And you're gonna need it after I'm done with you. In this chest are the two ingredients of Wigan Weld potion. Flubberworm. Flubberworm. Wigan tree bark. Take them out. Flubberworm. Flubberworm mucus. That's what he calls his sperm.
Oh, come on, Jonathan. That was a bit out.
I mean, flubberworm. That makes sense as well.
Try not to observe Mr. Potter adding the ingredients.
Whoa!
And mixing them. Careful, Potter. You don't want to lose house points. Mr. Potter...
They'll fall in the pan. Potion.
To drink the potion, press space bar.
I bet it's just like back to your seat. Some rape drug or something. Those of
you who are space bar? Do you have to go to a computer and press a space bar?
That's what I always thought as well as a kid, like... Why the hell is he telling me to press? Like this one throughout Hogwarts.
They are the only cauldrons in which Wigan Weld potions can.
So really, the best concoction was the person who made that cauldron, not the person who thought of the potion. Be found throughout
Hogwarts. Mm-hmm. Now for today's lecture. The history of
flubberworm mucus extraction.
I want to hear about that actually. That sounds very
I don't know, it sounds like jacking off. I knew everything I wanted to about flubberworm mucus, and I was right. Oh my god. Well,
I
thought he touched on some
interesting aspects. Let's get going. I agree with her. Comes out.
You're such
before
a nerd.
Snape comes out.
Malprocious.
Let me rape you?
Yeah. Let me rape you.
That's what it sounded like he said.
Yeah, especially with that accent, it's like when he says "rip," it sounds like it's rape in his accent.
Oh yeah, that's a bit of lowbrow comedy for you lowbrow comedy fans out there.
Ba-dum-tsh. Aren't we all fans of it?
I'm a fan of eyebrow comedy.
Yeah. Jesus. Oh yeah. That just really looks pasted on.
Someone did this in MS Paint in like 2 seconds. Horrible.
What's going on? Wow, if they acted so badly, like, I'd immediately suspect them doing it.
Yeah, I know, right?
If I would come running here and I'd hear them go, "Oh no, what's gone wrong?" Or something like that, like, the horror. Wow, he's quick. I cannot say. Too much flubberworm mucus. Everybody to please return to their dormitories. Look, it's all over the floor as well.
What, the water?
The flubberworm mucus. There's nothing more to see here. Wow. He's one of his lackeys.
What a kiss ass.
Everyone at Hogwarts was disturbed by
good old Steven.
Mrs. Norris and the mysterious words scrawled
with
rumors and stories. You know, there's this TV show that I used to watch as a kid called Pocoyo, and I don't really realize like the other week that Stephen Fry does the narration for that as well.
Jesus. Tight-lipped. Jesus. She remained tight-lipped.
We have to get to charms class, Harry, and I have an idea.
An idea about what?
We should ask Professor Flitwick about the Chamber of Secrets.
Flitwick.
He's bound to know something. Let's go.
Professor... even though Professor Snape's flubberworm mucus extraction
God, you
was
can't get over that, can you?
Sorry.
You
but it just all, it all ties in. I mean, all of a sudden he's going on about Hermione being tight-lipped.
And raping and that kind of stuff.
Yeah, so I mean, yeah, maybe I'm just...
Of course you want to find sexual innuendos in this game.
Yeah, I mean, it, maybe I'm just in a, you know, lowbrow mood or something.
Coming, maybe you are.
Maybe it'll change through the course
How
of this.
How did Hermione get up there when there's no staircase there?
She's a bloody witch.
She's a mudblood, remember?
Or maybe she uses those things.
Ah,
there's no way
that
she
spell, apparently.
Nah. Yeah, well, she gets she spends a lot of time in you know, after class stuff.
Come on now.
Learning all the tricks.
Look, Jimmy Savile is back in the news. I don't really want to think about that kind of stuff.
Is
right
he?
Now, okay.
Why?
Yeah, he is. He is. He apparently, did you hear this one?
He no. Used his, probably not then.
His celebrity his status. One. Okay, right. He uses celebrity status to get alone time with patients in hospitals. So
yeah, we knew about that already.
Yeah, it just happened this week. It was just in the news this week.
It just happened this week after
well,
he died?
It was in the news this week, okay? You cunt.
But it was already in the news before as well, though. I'm pretty sure I heard about that whole thing with the hospital stuff before.
And he raped a 75-year-old.
Wow.
He can't be convicted of raping only underage women. Okay?
Well, he
okay?
can't be convicted at all.
He goes, yes. That's true, isn't it?
Hey.
Heck, blast it, Potter. I'll get you.
What?
Ooh, you'll get me. But like...
Then for what?
But, yeah, for bumping into him or something. But like, what's it called, I always hate it, well, sometimes it's funny, when, like, voice actors read, like, when there's a line that says, like, ack, it means, you know, that they just have to basically, they don't have to literally say ack, you know?
Yeah,
you know
yeah,
I mean?
They're supposed to be like, ugh, or something, like, ah.
Yeah, but you, but it's just for the sake of sort of writing or something. That
it's onomatopoeia.
Yeah, and then, and he actually goes, like, ack. I mean, who the fuck does
that? I have a question there. Why the fuck was he just sweeping the floor when there's a massive blood stain on the wall that he hasn't cleaned off yet?
Yeah, he likes Slytherin stuff, like with the whole beware shit.
Tell us something about the Chamber of Secrets.
Tell us that fast. Miss Granger, not myths and legends. The hell? His, like, beard is, like, stuck to his shirt.
Just like with Dumbledore. Gryffindor, Salazar Slytherin, Helga Hufflepuff, and Rowena Ravenclaw. Slytherin. If you wanted to be like a headmaster of this school, you had to be, or a founder, you had to have like alliteration in your names. Yes,
Miss Granger. Godwin Gryffindor. One of my best friends is actually his last name is Salazar, and we used to always bring that up to him because Salazar Slytherin. Okay, why is there a capital letter on air in the middle of that sentence there?
Huh. Not wizard born, weird. Will be purged from Hogwarts. Wow. Listen to this bloody racial... Mr. Potter, perhaps
you'd like to step forward and demonstrate... Back to magic reality. Something about that just is funny to me.
But like, imagine if Dumbledore were to just walk by or something and like hear him another phallus symbol. But also like, if it were
oh my god, it is a phallic symbol. Jesus Christ.
But if he were to walk in or by and hear him going like,
oh, every non-Slytherin will be purged from this earth and school and stuff.
You think he's like some kind of racial purist or something?
Yeah, it's like a magic holocaust or something.
Oh, now I'm really, you know, moving my wand across the symbol.
Yeah, see, if you just tilt it slightly to the right, it does
sword
actually...
sword fighting.
Thank you for that Harry. Lovely image, you've advanced Jonathan. To the next level of the lesson. I don't know why I'm five calling you Jonathan. Yeah. Jesus,
oh well.
5 points.
Go.
5 points for touching my dick.
Oh my god.
This will forever be known as the part where...
left, right, left.
With the shitty well sexual done, innuendo. Harry. You've advanced to the next level of the
lesson. 10 points to Gryffindor. 10 points?
It would be good if, like, for every level, the symbol would grow a little. Oh my god.
10 points, yes, you've advanced to the next level.
And then it grows holy a bit shit larger.
Oh my god, look at all these arrows. There are a lot of phallic symbols on the screen right now. 20 points, 20 points. 15 points. 15, you cunt, that's not right. Well done, Mr.
Potter. You've successfully that's not right, as he wipes his mouth. Now it's time for you to test your newly learned knowledge in the Skurge spell challenge. Oh yeah, Skurge. I called that Splurge in the...
Skurge and me welcome films. Welcome, Harry Potter, to my Skurge challenge. To complete the challenge, you must find the completion star, which can be found several floors below us. His Skurge challenge.
Yeah, look at that. It's all the way down. But I always like it when it's like sort of close, you know, yet so far away.
I love that camera thing there through the grates. Very nice and cinematic. Challenge stars will boost your timer and score. I highly recommend. We already know this.
This is true. The completion star with as many seconds remaining as possible. The higher your score is when you complete the challenge, the more house points I will award
you. You know, like, the whole point of the first movie was the house point shit, right? I mean, not really, but like they love the house points in the first movie. And so as the movies went on, Harry just did not care about the house point system anymore.
Well, you know, Harry's a cunt.
I don't think he got a single house point in the entire, like, third movie to the last movie.
I'm kind of wasting points here, probably, but oh well. But yeah, I mean, as the films went on, Harry Potter just became more and more of a cunt. And the books, I suppose. You can cast Skurge to get rid of it. I mean, I really hate Harry Potter. I mean, I hate Frodo as well, from all those main characters who, like, get, like, all this, you know,
attention.
Look, it's down there. Can you see it?
That's cool.
But they get, like, all the, they get all the honor or something, even though they...
I don't know. Neville got a lot of honor in the...
Well, they mess everything up, really. Well, Neville wasn't that great either. Snape was the real hero, and he didn't get anything.
Snape was... Actually, he was, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Because he...
I mean, he bloody made Harry Potter. I mean, he wouldn't even have won the Triwizard Tournament if it wasn't for him.
But then Snape also did, like, he killed Dumbledore, so...
Yeah, but...
Spoilers.
But Dumbledore was already dying, so it was staged.
It was... Oh, that's right, it was staged, wasn't it? I need to watch the last couple movies again. I haven't seen them in, like, years.
I haven't seen those films, actually, either, but from the book,
books?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because I stopped watching after four. How many cards do we have, actually?
How many cards do you have?
Ooh, see, two left, and then for every 10, you get a new health bar, like a new lightning bolt.
That is pretty cool. It's like the heart containers from Legend of Zelda. Yeah. Or the something in Croc does the same thing. I can't remember what it is, but something.
Wait, am I doing something? Oh, I think I need to push it off further.
I think
not. No, I don't. What the? How do I not? Okay, I must be able to.
Is there a spell that lets you do it?
Ooh.
Oh, there you go.
Huh, strange. Oh, but yeah, so, and, I mean, literally, Harry, like, got everything handed to him by Snape. Like, any time that he was, like, having to be clever or having to get anything done, Snape just sort of went, like, eh, and arranged it for him. Like, with every Triwizard thing.
Yeah, that's right, yeah.
Every one of them, like the underwater one as well, like all of a sudden at the end
he's just that Neville will help him with the gillyweed shit.
Yeah. And like all of a sudden he found this shit with which he could breathe underwater or something.
Oh no, it's Peeves!
Well, if it isn't spotty, grotty, snotty, potty water, I like it. Uh-huh. It rhymes with
wait, did he say watty twice?
Aha!
Why am I using Skurge on him?
Speaking of, wait, this is what's
Jesus,
his
that guy's loud.
That's Peeves, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's, he was supposed to be voiced by the late Rik Mayall in the original Harry Potter. What do you mean, late?
Did you call him late?
He's dead.
Rik Mayall isn't dead.
What do you mean Rik Mayall isn't dead?
Look him up.
Where have you been for the last week and a half? 2 weeks.
Week and a half?
Rik Mayall died.
Like what? In like 2 weeks ago?
Yes, as in really recently, as in like less than a week ago or something.
What? Well, that's why I don't know. And I don't follow the news.
9th of June, he died on the 9th of June.
What? From what? Another accident?
Heart attack, I think.
What the fuck? I bet he was a booze hound.
He was 56 years old.
Yeah. Far too young.
Yep, he died.
I mean, he already died, like, he already almost died, like, a couple years ago or something, when he fell off some kind of... I think he fell off a quad bike or something. Or whatever he was... Oh, look at that, there's something down there. And we're going to explore it.
Well, Stephen Fry did pay his tributes, you know.
Really?
Yep.
Well, he was Stephen Fry was featured in an episode of look, this is pretty cool as well. Cool mechanic.
Young ones?
Yeah, the young ones, yeah.
Not to mention they were both in Blackadder as well.
Who, Rik Mayall?
Hmm.
I didn't even know Rik Mayall was in Blackadder.
Yeah, Lord Flashart.
Well, I didn't see all of Blackadder because it, like, after the second season, it just bored me to death for some reason.
He was in the second season.
Oh. Oh, that's weird. Maybe I did see him, but just forget about him. But yeah, it's not like he was gonna really do anything. Like,
yeah, I know,
you know
what you're saying.
He pretty much lived his life already.
Come on.
Why, he'd gone to shit the last years. He hadn't made anything worthwhile. I guess Bottom or something was like, or Bottoms or whatever it was called, was like his last well-known work or something.
What about Drop Dead Fred? Is that before Bottom?
I don't know.
He was in an episode of Midsummer Murders.
Yeah, but that's like one of those things where like... they bring, like, these guest people on who used to be famous or something, you know what I mean?
Used to be? Okay.
Well, who used to have stuff going on.
Well, you know,
yes! Look at that!
What?
We got the second lightning bolt.
You know Rik Mayall is going to be in this movie coming out next year that he just completed filming before he died?
Well, lucky
called
him.
Called The Escape.
It's probably that which caused the heart attack, or the, you know, work and stuff on that.
I think he was in stage or something towards the end, or...
Well, yeah, he did a lot of, theatre.
And also, he was in a few random TV shows. He did that one TV show called King Arthur's Disasters, which I used to watch when I was a wee lad.
Is that a comedy?
Yeah, it's like an animated show. It's a cartoon.
I got, oh, fuck. This guy's got no willpower. He didn't even keep following me. Wait a second. Yeah, I need to put one of them on there, and it's going to take bloody ages. I love how this bloody episode, or whatever it is just turned into talking about the life and times of Rik Mayall.
Rik Mayall.
Well, then again, you know, you got to pay your tributes.
Well, he was in this universe. He played Peeves in the deleted scenes from the first Harry Potter movie.
In the deleted scene.
Yeah, he was in the deleted scene.
You know, he had a role in the deleted scenes of a very popular film.
He was so good, he was in the deleted scenes.
Jesus. So Peeves was in the books then as well.
Peeves was in the books, yep.
Because I didn't read... It was like pretty much the opposite. Jesus, the opposite of the films for me. I didn't read books 1 and 2. I started reading them from 3 onward, and then and the films I stopped watching from 4 onward or something. Wait, do I need to jump down here, or am I gonna be there anyway? Because I don't want to miss something. Yeah, I'm gonna jump down there. See what's up there. No! Wait, are you still there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, Jesus. I thought I'd lost you for a second.
What did you think happened? Well, so sorry. Do I have to validate everything you see?
No. But what the hell? You reckon... I bet there was something down there. Damn it.
Well, you'll never know now.
Never.
Well, you might know now.
No, I don't think... Well, who knows? Oh, is this going to be one of those pixies? Yeah.
A Cornish pixie. Troublesome and annoying creatures they are. If they touch you, they will bite, so try to avoid them. Rictus Emperor will stun them.
They're not That's very gentle lovers.
Well, apparently, according to this, Peeves has appeared in all of the books, but none of the films. A scene with Peeves was filmed
All of the books? I never remember reading about him in, in any books.
Anyway, yeah, a scene with Peeves was filmed for the film adaptation of The Philosopher's Stone. It was left on the cutting room floor and to date has never been released in any form.
Wow, it was just completely shit.
Think about this. That could have been Rik Mayall's ticket to stardom.
No. Mm-hmm. I mean, he only did a voiceover, right?
Yeah, but think about it. He could have been like...
I mean, he would have been perfect for his voice, to be honest.
Yeah, it would have been.
I mean, he really does have that, like, peevesy voice.
That peevish voice.
Ooh, this is kind of dangerous. Ooh. What was that? Holy shit. Finding the secrets. Ooh. Yeah. What's down here? Another card.
Another card?
We're gonna have... Once we have 10 of those, we get to open one bar of the door. Who was that?
Who was that guy? Who are these people in these cards? I've never seen them before.
Gregory the Smarmy Medieval. The Smarmy Medieval. Dates unknown, famous originator of Gregory's unctuous unction. Potion to persuade the drinker that the giver is their very best friend, alleged to have wormed his way into King Richard's confidence and thus made his fortune.
Wonder if that has anything to do with the potion he made. Probably not. Oh, look at this platforming shit.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Harry Potter has it all.
Mm-mm. Well, this castle has it all. I mean, where the fuck did they leave all this?
That always baffled me. I mean, I suppose it's a magic castle, but still.
Yeah, but that's... I mean, I do like that, though. How there's all this... just the level design is really great. All this weird shit in here that looks like sort of intriguing. Yep. I mean, what the hell is this? Who the fuck? It's like some hobo corner here or something.
Some hobo corner. Or someone just left a lamp, not a lamp, a chair lying around.
Yeah, or it's like one of those artists, you know, who's just sitting here and like taking the scenery in, and he's got like his thing with canvases, and then this is like, you know, the frames, and he's just painting the scenery, and then
well, why would you paint that? It looks shit.
Doesn't look shit.
Well, there's better things to paint than this.
Look, there's a cool hallway there, and there's like some weird shit up there.
Yeah, but, okay, whatever.
But, you know, maybe he wasn't just painting here, you know. This is just one of the rooms that he visited. Or it was just one of those street artists.
One of those street artists.
Except yeah. This isn't quite a street, but I think I need to go up somewhere first. Make something land on that to provide the counterweight.
The counterweight? Look at this game teaches you about physics. It's crazy.
Yeah. Crazy.
Man, this must be easy to program. They just repeated the same hallway thing a few times.
Oh, no. I think it looks quite dynamic.
Ooh. Those guys.
Shaking their tushies again.
This room, what is the purpose of this room? It takes an age to get to, and there's no real...
Well, you know, what was the purpose of that weird platform that for some reason had to be,
What are you doing with that thing?
Oh.
Ah.
Wow, he's got some arm strength.
Oh, shit, the phone's ringing. Back in 2 seconds.
Oh, boy. Maybe, I'll just pause.